The chair made a judgment that was immediate and undifferentiated. But measurement has to be a psychological tool, not a technical tool. Measurement plays a role of objective criterion and have to allow the child to focus on objective parameters of an object. Clearly, that it was needed to create a new mediated mode of thought. Firstly, at the external, secondly, at the internal level, fixed it. Only after doing all this, we could ask child to solve the Piagetian exercises. The act of learning of how to carry out mediate evaluation of the various parameters of an object had several steps. First, comparing quantity of two groups of objects, one-to-one correspondence, discrete object directly. Second, comparing quantity of two group of objects mediated by marks, discrete object mediated. Comparing of length of two objects directly, continue directly. Comparing of length two objects by means of the third one, continue mediated. Use a real measurement by dividing object into the parts. We can see the first step. Comparing quantity of two groups of objects, one-to-one correspondence, discrete objects directly. You can see. In this way, child can say absolutely exactly where more these things. Comparing quantity of two group object mediated by marks, discrete object mediated. We presented the child some card with cutouts stuck on a card in the random order. You can see the child must do such. Child put, for example, a rod on each fox and a counter on each duck. And then he can make such. Having established one-to-one correspondence, the child was able to give the right answer to the question. Some example, the same. You can use such pictures. Now, it is necessary to compare of length of two objects directly. This is continual, and this is made compare directly. You can see. Compare of length to object directly. You can see. And now child can say, where is more? Compare of length of two objects by means of the third one, continuum mediated. The child had to cut a length of the strip that was exactly the length of one of the cartouches and then place it on the other to see whether it was larger or smaller. This step consisted of learning how to compare two objects by means of the third one. We set up an exercise in which direct comparison of the dimensions of the figures was impossible. The third object had to be used. The child had to cut the strip of paper and use it to compare the lengths of two objects. But the comparison through the third element is not a real measurement. It isolates the parameter and indicates its value, but it is itself is an independent concrete object. Now, it is necessary to compare of length of two objects directly. This is continual, and this is made compare directly. You can see, compare of length to object directly. You can see. And now a child can say, very small. Compare of length of two objects by means of the third one, continuum mediated. The child had to cut a length of the strip that was exactly the length of one of the cartouches and then place it on the other to see whether it was larger or smaller. This step consisted of learning how to compare two objects by means of the third one. We set up an exercise in which direct comparison of the dimensions of the figures was impossible. The third object had to be used. The child had to cut the strip of paper and use it to compare the lengths of two objects. But the comparison through the third element is not a real measurement. It isolates the parameter and indicates its value, but it is itself is an independent concrete object. Third element is not an instrument that transforms the measured size into quantity. Usage of real measurement by dividing object to the parts, in this example, what the child have to do is to compare, for example, length to slanted lines or two paths using a small strip of paper. And after this, he can use this orientation card and make compare what is larger. The length was measured and compared using the marks. And in this information the child wrote in the card scheme. Example of this exercises. After this, we teach children to use a measuring instrument and marks in different situations. We gave the child real objects, two rods, two books, some cartons and a stone, a nail and a pencil, etc. and asked the child to measure and compare objects by a different parameter dimension, length, breadth, height, area, weight. The mode of reasoning thus formed was then transposed to Piagetian and similar exercises, including the parameter of length, area, distance, weight, and volume. Children solve the Piagetian exercise. Conservation of length, area, distance, weight, and volume. Different either in structure, discrete and continuous quantity, or in material, modeling clay, liquids, etc. All exercises were made correctly, and children always could justify their answers. Result. First, child begins to make a distinguish between what seems to be and what actually exists. The child passes beyond the limit of his or her immediate experience and sees for the first time the possibility of truly scientific understanding of the world. When we teach children how to use an objective criterion to isolate parameters and how to convert them into mathematical quantity and establish one-to-one correspondence between them, the child's initial idea about things is their way modified. The transition to scientific thought is a modification of the picture of the world. As a rule, things appear to the child as they immediately seems to him, even if there should be something behind the external aspect of the object. It remains mysterious and hidden from the child. Before our teaching, the children always took the appearance as reality. After our teaching, children begin to make a distinction between what seems to be and what actually exists. The use of measurement became for a child a new method of exploring of the environment. We taught the children to use a special scheme to represent the structure of the essential properties of the objects. This schematic representation of the essential relations between objects is the outward manifestation of what will subsequently be the inner framework of the child's reasoning. At the scientific level of thought, the child arrives at a judgment that is immediate and egocentric. In our experiments, we taught the children to assess objects by measurement, which serves to give material expression to the object attitude to things. In conclusion, repeat again. We constructed our experiment in accordance to Galperin's method of the systematic formation of mental action. This method enables us to instill new knowledge into the subjects, but it has also revealed something else to us, namely how the elements of scientific thought take shape. The new result of this investigation is the construction of operative schema of thinking on the basis of measure. Very important. As the result of such kind of teaching, the decalage was absent. The second type of investigation, solving of the open tasks. Goal, the aim of this investigation, to create a system of condition which will allow to receive many decisions of problem drawing pictures. It was necessary remind very important concept, Vygotsky concept about ideal form. Before we must understand what is ideal form for these open tasks. Let's agree, Vygotsky writes, let's agree to name the developed form which should appear in the end of children's development, a final or ideal. Ideal in the sense that is the sample of that should appear in the end of development. For us, in our experiment, the ideal form drawing of adults, ideal form opens for us the possibility to find the qualitative criteria of success in the decision of divergent problems. This is, you see, adult draw pictures. Very important, it was necessary. This is investigation for me is new variant of technique of double stimulation, Vygotsky technique double stimulation, but this is new variant, I think. It is necessary to design of means of orientation. This means war magic windows. You can see. I will see it for you also. I have. You can see it later also. This is magic. Magic windows helps the child to find their decision. They remind the child familiar situation, fairy tales, fantastic characters, etc. We will see drawing of children of 5 years in forming series. This is very simple pictures. Children at 5 years. Drawing children of 6 years in the same series. We can see more pictures and more interesting pictures also. You can see. Drawing of children of 7 years. The result of such teaching preschool children could make many different pictures. And the third type of investigation, it is very difficult for me because this is very new investigation. The formation of concepts with complete characteristics. Howard Gardner's article, Feeling of Style at Children, was the source of this research. The aim is to construct the system of condition for understanding the style of painting by children from 10 to 12 years old who start visiting museums, choose clubs and studios. Some of them are taught at art school. The style of painting is very complicated notion because it has many uncertain characteristics. The artistic style combined content and formal elements typical for a certain historical period. Our hypothesis: the comprehension of artist image structure, of painting means, of artwork style by children of 10 to 12 years is also possible on the basis of Galperin's theory and method. This method includes the solving of several tasks. To discover the initial level estimation of painting perception and comprehension by children. To analyze the reason about paintings of different epoch by expert, ordinary and art school children. To define the zone of proximal development for our subjects. To choose material for analyze. And you can see our material.